channel Shweta Makeup and Beauty and I hope you all are doing good. And Shubh Navratri, Shubh Durga Puja to all of you. May the blessing of Durga Ma be always with you. So today's video is a makeup tutorial video in which I have tried to create a makeup look for Durga Puja. And this look, as you can see, is inspired from Bengali Durga Puja looks. I really like the way how red, gold and white look together, so I just wanted to try some look of that sort. And I am wearing a white, gold and red net sari and some jewelry which I really like to wear. So I really hope you like this makeup look, and I was eagerly waiting for Durga Puja since a long time because I am really really close to Durga Ma. So it's finally here and I am so excited. So I'm a North Indian, and in North India we celebrate it for whole 9 days. We keep fast for whole 9 days, or we keep fast for first and last day of Navratras. So in the evening we go to temples to offer our prayers to Durga Ma, and on 8th or 9th day we used to offer our prasad or food to 9 little girls, and we call it Kanya. So this is how we celebrate Navratri in North India. So let me know in the comment section below how you celebrate your Durga Puja. I would love to read them all. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel for more such videos. And don't forget to like this video and comment down below how you like this makeup tutorial. We have talked a lot, so now let's zoom and move on to the makeup tutorial. Now, to make a makeup long lasting and to make a smooth canvas for the makeup, I am using this Color Bar Perfect Match Primer and massaging this all over my face. Next, I am using this Maybelline The Nudes palette for my eye makeup, and I am using this shimmery brown shade and applying it onto the crease of my eyes. And then using this bronzy golden shade, I'm applying it towards the corner of my eyelids and moving it towards the center of my eyelids. Next, I'm using this golden shimmery shade and applying it onto the center of my lids and smudging it towards the corner and just buffing it out. And this will make sure that my eyes look more defined and it will not look flat. Next, I'm using my Maybelline Lumitouch concealer and drawing an inverted triangle under my eyes and also applying it onto the temple, onto the bridge of my nose and side of my lips to highlight those areas, and also on the chin. And now I'm using my Real Technique Damn Beauty Blender and smudging all the concealer. Next, I'm using my Maybelline Infallible Foundation, and I guess it was in the shade 150, and I'm applying it onto my face and onto my neck. And then using my Damp Real Technique Beauty Blender, I just blended everything nicely onto my skin. Now please remember that while applying foundation, don't forget your neck, because you don't want your face to look different from your neck. So take your time and just blend everything very nicely onto the skin. Next, I'm using this banana shade powder from my Makeup Revolution Ultra Contour palette, and I'll apply it under my eyes to set my concealer, and this will make sure my concealer doesn't crease out. Next, I'm using my Nashio Brow Kit to define my brows, and I'm using a spoolie first to brush my brows. And then using a dark brown shade, I'm outlining my brows. And
After I have outlined my brows, I'll just fill it with the same brow powder, and then using a spoolie, I'll just brush my brows. Next, I'm using my Maybelline Colossal Liner to line my eyelids, and I really like this Colossal Liner because it's really easy to use and it helps me to create a winged eyeliner without any fuss. So I like to create my winged eyeliner really slowly, and then I like to build it up because I am really not good in creating any winged eyeliner. Next, I'm using my Maybelline liquid liner, and I'm just going on top of my previous liner so that the look is more defined and more dark. Next, I'm using my Maybelline Colossal Kajal and I'm applying it onto my lower waterline. And then I'm using the same kajal to tight line my eyes, just to make my lashes look more fuller. And then I'm using the same nudes palette and using the brown shade and just smudging it onto my lower waterline. Now this will help in creating more soft and smoked out look. So I personally like using this technique for my lower waterline. And then using my Vega eyelash curler, I curl my lashes. Next, I'm using my Maybelline Volume Express mascara to coat my eyelashes. Next, I'm using my Makeup Revolution Ultra Contour Palette to contour the hollows of my cheeks and my jawline. So I really like using this palette because it just gives me the perfect pigment. So I like to mix a brown shade and a lighter brown shade together to get that perfect shade for my skin tone. Contouring defines the bone structure of your face. As you can clearly see, my cheekbones are now more defined, and now I'm applying it to my jawline and just bringing the color back towards my neck. This helps in defining my jawline, and if you have any double chin, it will also help in concealing that. Now I'm using a lighter shade to further highlight my cheekbones and the area above my jawline. I'm also applying it onto the areas where I have highlighted using concealer before, and now I'm using this illuminator to highlight my cheekbones, and it just brings a soft dewy glow to the face. I also like to apply it onto high points of my face like tip of my nose, cupid bows, temple and my chin. Now using Maybelline Cheeky Glow Blush, I'm just applying it onto my cheeks just to bring a flush of color. While applying blush, don't push the brush towards your face, just slightly shrug it off your cheeks so that the color is not highly pigmented on your cheeks. Now coming to the lips, I'm applying a Maybelline lip liner first to line my lips. Next, I'm using my Lakme lip color in the shade R352 and applying it all over my lips. Next, I used a tissue to wipe off the excess product, and to make my lip color more vibrant, I used NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the shade Amsterdam and I'm applying it on to my Lakme lip color. So as you can see, the color looked more vibrant now. And a traditional look is never complete without some chudi and jhumki. So I am wearing some golden chudis and golden jhumkis. And I applied a bindi to complete my look. So I really hope you like this makeup tutorial. And if you do so, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.